mountains don't fear the reaper, nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain. We can be like they are. Come on, baby, don't fear the reaper. Baby, take my hand. Don't fear the reaper. We'll be able to fly. Don't fear the reaper. Baby, I'm your man.
My editor, Ben Dodds, called me at 3 a.m. to give me the news. It was a woman this time, the third victim. Of all the reporters in the city, the Ripper picked me to write to. I knew that another mad letter to the city was soon to come, and I would run it on the front page of the Virtual Herald. I would let the world know the Ripper had killed again.
Hey, how you doing? I hope you haven't eaten yet, Quinlan.
Figured you'd get here sooner or later, Quinlan. You can't get enough of this story, can you?
I think everyone's had enough of this story, Magnata.
Don't go taking any souvenirs, Quinlan.
Same MO as the others?
You got it. Look around, you asshole. If anything, this is more gruesome than the other two. Hell of a lot more splatter.
Who's the victim?
Name's Stein. Renee Stein. Age 43. Book editor over at Knopf.
Any connection to the other two?
Well, let's see. Estevez was a programmer. Mendel, a dry cleaner. It'll take me 48 hours to run it down, but there's no connection here.
You have any clues?
No sign of forced entry. Nothing's disturbed. Two sets of prints. Hers and her mother's. The only thing not where it should be is this woman's insides.
Well, what about witnesses? I mean, this guy must have been a bloody mess. Even if it's 3 o'clock in the morning, it's Greenwich Village. Somebody must have seen him.
As far as I know, he left us with one witness, and she's feeling a little fragmented at the moment. This guy is unfucking believable.
Why is her computer on, Magnata?
Well, it looks like she was in a public library node. Well, let me ask you a question. You got any mail lately? Maybe a little something from your pen pal?
He writes after the fact, not before. You should know that, Magnata. I wouldn't hold out on you.
Of course not. You've been very good about sharing what you know with me and several million other people. I should have busted you when you ran that first letter without letting us know about it. All right, visiting hours over. There's nothing here you haven't seen at the other murder sites except a few extra gallons of body fluids.
Well, you shouldn't be touching anything, should you, Magnata?
I guess this case has me rattled.
Object scanned into database.
This shattered mug had something written on it. Salisbury. I wonder what that means.
Cold Carl Stasiak. We gotta stop meeting like this. Carl!
Sorry, Quinlan. What'd you say?
Is there any difference between this murder and the previous ones?
It was identical. Absolutely identical. It was a precision cut. A perfect line. And the way he empties out the body cavity. The way the organs are blown all around the room.
So it's the same killer?
Oh, for sure. I mean, the organs, they're completely cut to pieces. I've never seen anything like this in my life. It's amazing.
Want any clues to how it's done?
Don't ask me. You'd think I'd be used to seeing things like this by now. But I'm not. Whoever did this is beyond madness. It's pure evil.
Any progress in the investigation?
Who knows? Trying to get anything out of Magnotta is next to impossible. Besides, if he does have a lead, he sure as hell never share it. He might lose his bounty if he does that.
Well, you've been working with Magnotta for years, Carl. What's your hunch?
Well, something's bugging him. Who am I to talk? I'm having nightmares about this. I've been a forensic photographer for 22 years, and nothing's ever got to me like this. Now I can't sleep.
Well, you just need a vacation, that's all.
Yeah, I hope you're right.
Any idea what weapon he's using?
Take a look at this mess. It has to be something big. A sword or a machete or something. Just can't cut through all that bone and muscle with a dagger. And the strength it would take to make a cut like that, he must be an enormous man. You know Vic Farley?
Yeah, the pathologist over at the Medicog.
He knows a lot more about murder weapons than I do. You should talk to him.
Incoming WAC transmission.
Quinlan here. Hey, Catherine.
Hey, Jake. How are things there?
Well, it's very... red.
What, anything different this time?
Just the name, Catherine.
Listen, Jake, something's come up here.
Something about the Ripper?
Might be nothing. I don't know. It could be something big. Just wait for me at the newsroom and I'll let you know as soon as I find out.
Now talk to me. What's going on?
I have to go. Trust me.
Who's in charge here?
Well, after last night, I'd say that I am.
So all of a sudden, you don't have to explain yourself to me?
Look, if you don't hear from me in an hour, just go to my apartment and wait for me there. You can hang out with my crystals.
Catherine! Oh, shit. What's going on, Ben? Did Catherine get a break in the Ripper story?
I don't know, Jake. I thought you were the lead reporter in the story.
Well, so did I. Do you know what she's up to?
She's your assistant. You tell me. She ran out of here like the place was on fire.
Did another letter from the Ripper come in?
No, you know he doesn't send them to anybody but you.
Then I guess we're just gonna have to wait and see. Catherine and I met on the job. Despite reminding myself that mixing love and work can get messy, it didn't take long for it to become more than a professional relationship. She was supposed to be my assistant, but she was beginning to act like it was her story. I only hoped that whatever lead she had, she wasn't in over her head.
Incoming WAC transmission. Source unknown.
Dear boss, have you seen my work this morning yet? Your stories make the cops seem so confident. None of you know how I do it. You never will. You shouldn't let your girlfriend do your work for you. She is close to me, and I'm not laughing. She's my next job. She gets it today. The story's all yours. Yours truly, Ripper.
Catherine.
Quinlan. Where are you going? Quinlan! Quinlan!
Usually it takes an hour to cross that part of Manhattan. I did it in 20 minutes, propelled by kicking myself in the ass for letting Catherine go out alone. I was scared as hell when I got there, but everything looked okay in her apartment. Until Catherine showed up, that is.
Catherine, what is going on here? Catherine, what is it? What is wrong? What happened? What? No, Catherine! Catherine! No! Catherine! Fuck! Catherine, please, Catherine! Fuck!
The good news was Catherine wasn't dead. The bad news was that she was in a coma deeper than anyone thought possible. The ever-helpful Detective Magnata had her brought to the Tribeca Center for Cyber Studies, also known as the Medicog. Meanwhile, I stopped off at the police station to see a few sources and try to retrieve Catherine's portable WAC. Hopefully, she'll have left me a message.